Media Matters. It calls itself a progressive research and information center. The group is now under fire for attacking Christian news outlets.
And now CBN News has obtained a document showing that the very foundation of Media Matters is built on anti-Christian bias. Eric Stackelbeck has this exclusive report from Washington.
Media Matters for America is a nonprofit liberal watchdog group that has the ear of not only the mainstream media, but also the Obama administration. As part of its strategy, Media Matters frequently targets Christian organizations. Why would they do that? This document obtained by CBN News provides some of that answer. You're looking at an application for nonprofit status with the IRS that Media Matters filed in 2004. In the section asking for the description of its mission, they explain, Media Matters for America believes that news reporting and analysis by the American media has become biased. It is common for news and commentary by the press to present viewpoints that tend to overly promote a conservative Christian-influenced ideology. The Daily Caller's Vince Colonnaise is one reporter that's investigated the group's attacks on Christian organizations.
Media Matters, in its application to the IRS, outright, in its very first paragraph, declares it's going to be an anti-Christian organization. Interestingly, though, in their public mission statement, Media Matters makes no mention of the fact that it intends to target the Christian ideology.
Media Matters did not respond to CBN's request for comment on this story or the document. David Brog, executive director of Christians United for Israel, believes Media Matters' targeting of Christians is connected to its anti-Israel views.
They want to take on what they see as a Christian-influenced media and Christian-influenced policy. If you're going to take on Christian-influenced policy, no better place to start than with the issue of Israel and with attacking U.S. support for Israel.
Until recently, the man at the center of Media Matters' anti-Israel campaigns was M.J. Rosenberg. He served as the group's senior foreign policy fellow before stepping aside amid controversy over his anti-Israel writings, including heated criticism from well-known Democrats like attorney Alan Dershowitz. Rosenberg routinely uses the label Israel Firsters, implying that American supporters put the interest of Israel above the United States. It's a charge commonly made by neo-Nazis and anti-Semitic groups.
We don't see any condemnation of his hate language coming from Media Matters, and we have yet to notice any shift in editorial policy. So for all we know, they've said goodbye to the man, but not the message. And I call upon all my friends on the left who love Israel, who hate anti-Semitism, speak up. Your silence is deafening. You're letting your compatriots get away with the vilest of accusations.
Media Matters' new Middle East expert seems to be following in the footsteps of his predecessor. He recently blasted DNC chairwoman Debbie Wasserman Schultz for pulling out of an event that was hosted by a Muslim leader whose name is on the federal terrorist watch list. Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News, Washington.
Let me underline the significance of this story. This group, Media Matters, has it's documented they have regular meetings with the White House press secretary at the White House. They have access into that kind of power, if you will, and they're actively shaping the message and doing that with effect. Here is the group that has taken credit for taking Lou Dobbs off of CNN. They've also taken credit for taking Glenn Beck off of Fox News. That's the type of organization we're dealing with. They're targeting specifically Christian viewpoints in news stories. So when you see them cited in a news story, please let your voice be heard that a respected news organization doesn't need to be quoting from a group that says we're out to target Christians. Lee Webb has the rest of our top stories from the CBN newsroom.
Gordon, a growing number of Democrats are worried that President Obama's health care law could hurt them in this year's elections. Many believe that their party pushed the bill through Congress when it should have focused more on the economy. And some are worried about the cost of the measure. Others in Congress are not worried about the impact of the law this November. But former Representative Arthur Davis from Alabama told the Hill.com that the public just doesn't like Obamacare. He says it's the single least popular piece of major domestic legislation in the last 70 years. It was not popular when it passed, he says. It's less popular now. There are new signals that the economy may be slowing down again. Rising gas prices, weak home sales, and the potential for more layoffs are the biggest worries. The ongoing financial crisis in Europe and its effect on the U.S. is also a big deal. We will have a special report on the debt crisis in Europe on Monday's edition of the 700 Club. A computer may be a more effective treatment for teenage depression than a therapist. Researchers in New Zealand designed a specialized interactive fantasy game for a new study. They found 44% of teens who completed most of the game completely recovered from their depression. Only 26% of teenagers who received traditional therapy saw the same results. The National Institutes of Mental Health says 11% of 13 to 18-year-olds developed depression at some point along the way. But, Gordon, let me just say here, if I had a teenage child with depression, the last place I'm going to send them is to a computer to play a fantasy game.
Well, if it works, why not give it a try? Here's what the game does. What it does is it takes you through various levels where if you answer correctly with a positive thought, and it gives you tools to how to have positive thoughts that overcome negative thoughts. That's how this game is working. And as you progress through the levels, it actually is training your thought process in your brain so that you know how to recognize a negative thought. If you're around anyone with depression, it is an automatic that they take the negative view of any situation, and it's literally out of their control. And you hear again and again, you can't control your emotions. But what triggers emotions? Well, it's thought processes. And so if you can change how you think and start thinking the positive way, then there's a spill-on effect where you actually start feeling better. So if this game can do that, then my hat's off to
them. Yeah, must produce some of that dopamine stuff or whatever.
Sunlight and bananas.
Yeah.
Mitt Romney will give this year's commencement address at Liberty University. A campaign official tells CBN News that the evangelical school approached the former Massachusetts governor, and he gladly accepted. Graduation is May 12th in Lynchburg, Virginia, and it will be Mitt Romney's first appearance at Liberty. Operation Blessing, providing needy families with food through a hunger relief outreach program. OB donates food and supplies to 25 food pantries throughout the state of Florida. Tom is a 15-year Army veteran. He is not able to work because of injuries he sustained in combat. He and his wife are able to get enough groceries and personal care items, though, from these food pantries to get through the tough times. Operation Blessing's hunger relief outreach benefits more than 5,000 people every month. You can find out more about Operation Blessing by going to its website at ob.org.